Turning our attention now to the ASX, here's Matt Birney and Bulls and Bears with the latest public company views and interviews.
Welcome to Bulls and Bears, brought to you today by lithium battery manufacturer Magnis Energy Technologies, ASX code MNS. I'm Matt Birney and I'm joined now by the Executive Chairman of Magnis Energy Technologies, Frank Poullas. Hi, Frank.
Hi, Matt. Thanks for having me on.
Okay, so unlike other ASX companies who are still in the concept stage of building technologies associated with lithium batteries, Magnis Energy has leapfrogged them all, recently announcing it has commenced lithium battery manufacturing at its purpose-built factory in New York. And unlike many others who are just starting to dip their toe into the green battery technology space, Magnis will commence manufacturing using a proprietary green technology that has no need for hard-to-find metals like nickel and politically difficult metals like cobalt. Okay, Frank, a lot to unpack here. Firstly, how big is this factory? What percentage of it does Magnis own? And how many batteries a year are you looking to churn out?
The size of the actual factory is around 3 soccer fields in size. So we're talking about a considerable factory, very large. In regards to ownership, 60% ownership that Magnis has, it's just a bit above that. And its partner in C4V owns 33%. Then in regards to the amount of cells or batteries that we'll be producing each day, the plant has a capacity of 1.8 gigawatt hours of production, which we will ramp up to in the future. That would be producing 15,000 of these batteries per day.
Okay, without getting too technical, tell me about your battery making technology, and importantly, how do you manage to do away with nickel and cobalt?
So our technology around the cathode is called BMLMP. So it's a mixed metal phosphate technology, which has a coating which gives some really good performance. And the coating is sort of, you know, the secret sauce that goes above the cathode. We're able to eliminate nickel and cobalt and get results in regards to cell energy that are about 10% below the nickel and cobalt type batteries, but at a considerable discount to producing those batteries. So it's something that is not a new technology. That technology is about 10 years old that we've been working on, and that technology is US homegrown. So it is the first lithium ion gigafactory in the US using homegrown US technology.
Who do you sell the batteries to?
We currently have contracts above $700 million worth, and the majority are going into the energy stationary storage side, so sort of like grid applications. And in that, we do have a couple of customers that are defense suppliers to the US government.
I know the Biden government recently announced a number of financial credits for companies that are doing so-called green manufacturing. I'm guessing that may well apply to you in time. Frank Poullas from Magnis Energy Technologies, thanks for joining me on Bulls and Bears. And remember, we're only here to give you information, not advice, which you should, of course, seek independently. I'm Matt Birney, and this is Bulls and Bears.
For more public company CEO interviews, go to the Money page on the 6BR, 2GB and 3AW websites and click the Public Companies tab.